Let's spotlight one of the other wonderful nonprofits that's out there today. Joining us through the World Wide Webs, the internets, if you will, is Rudra Tsimsena. She's the board chair of Building Community in New Hampshire, serving refugee and immigrant populations throughout central New Hampshire. Rudra, can you hear us?
Yes, I can hear you.
Oh, there he is. So, Rudra, share with me your perspective on this day. We've just hit $1 million. And the donations continue. I mean,
I feel like you do. Look, you want to smile. It's just incredible.
Yeah. So I was so glad to see the highest number of donors donating to our organizations and supporting our cause.
Yeah. It's great.
So I'm glad that this is happening right now.
Tell us a little bit more about what you do, what your nonprofit does for refugees in central New Hampshire. How does it work?
I am the board chair of BCNH. Our organization, it's a mutual assistance association that provides services to refugees and immigrant communities in New Hampshire. We serve Concord, Manchester, and Nassau. We help newcomers understand and navigate the system that are part of everyday life. We were founded in 2009 as the Bhutanese Community of New Hampshire. But as the demand grew, we changed our name in 2017 as Building Community in New Hampshire. We provided services like we run civics classes to prepare for citizenship tests. We ran nutrition education program. We help kids learn from home when school went remote due to pandemic. We distributed PPEs. We recruited clients for vaccination clinic. Whenever an immigrant family come to our door for any help, we either help them or we refer to wherever they get help. This is all we do in New Hampshire.
I want to say congratulations, because in April, you received a pretty prestigious award from the New Hampshire Center for Nonprofits. You received the Nonprofit Impact Award for exceptional service to the community. That has to be gratifying.
That is right. And we want people to donate to us so that we can sustain this impact in the community.
So let me ask you, Rudra, we were talking just a couple of minutes ago to one of the other nonprofits who was talking about the challenge of dealing with affordable housing in New Hampshire. Considering this is such a core piece of what you do, how challenging is it for any family, much less the refugees that you serve, to find affordable housing in our great state?
It is very hard. As right now, the housing market has grown exponentially, and it's very hard to find housing right now. But we still have people intact living in New Hampshire and making their home. It is difficult.
What is it like? Tell me what you feel when you see you put a refugee family in a home, a safe home in New Hampshire. What does that feel like?
So I can reflect myself. I came to New Hampshire as a refugee from Bhutan. I spent 17 years in a refugee camp in Nepal. When I came here, a nonprofit like ours helped me from the beginning, whether it be going to hospital or taking a ride in a bus. People need help navigate through all the services in the United States. It's different from what they experience in their home back wherever they came from. So it is completely different here. So somebody who left their home and came to start a new life here in New Hampshire, they have to work from the beginning. So it makes us feel proud when they become a part of this community and they become a contributing member of the community.
It's a beautiful thing.
It's wonderful. Rudra, thank you so much for what you do. Thank you for your contributions to the refugee community in central New Hampshire and throughout the state. Congratulations on your award and very best of luck. Thanks so much for joining us
tonight. Nice work.
Thank you very much.
Take care.